Good morning, everybody. At the outset, I must congratulate and salute you people because you have taken a big task of making everybody knowledge-empowered librarians. We are not clapping because you are being given much because the profession, that your profession is of much importance. You have become the librarians. That means you are giving knowledge. You are inspiring the new generation with knowledge initiative. That's a great thing. That's a great thing. Now I would like to remember your mentor, Dr. Swaminathan. He is also from my own village town, hometown at Kuttanad. And we have met so many times, and I remember him also. I pay my respect and regards to him also. And I'm grateful to you for inviting me to this august audience by Mr. Nancy, Mr. Vignesh, etc. And it's a privilege for me to address, and I want to learn from you. In fact, instead of giving my address, I would like to learn from you, from your experience, since you are I am told by Dr. Shadi that you have become the innovators. That is what we need today. Innovators in library movement and library science, and Mr. Vijay Kumar is also here, a veteran library science. So let us learn. Let us learn. Let us put together our brains and let us learn. And we should do some innovative activities in the libraries with the help of Dr. Shadi, because he is always here a soft corner with libraries, I suppose, because every time, whenever he goes, he speaks about libraries and its innovation, how it can reach the poorest of the poor. Because our target should be to reach the poorest of the poor. We have to reach the poor. How we can reach the poor? Only through knowledge. Only because now we are in the era of knowledge economy. So knowledge is our main thirst. Only through knowledge we can build up our economy. Previously in 16th century was the era of agrarian economy that has failed. Then started this era of industrialization, industrial economy that has also failed. Now this era of knowledge that will sustain for years, because only through knowledge you can empower everybody. And even when people say how with the knowledge and books how we can eradicate poverty, yes, we can eradicate poverty only through knowledge. By acquiring knowledge and skills, we can eradicate poverty. So that's why I value your profession as a big thing. Librarians are the real torch bearers of knowledge, that you have to take it forward in an innovative way, because now the books are there in the libraries. Nobody is coming to their libraries and reading the books. You have to take the books to the masses. That has been done by Panicker. He has experience, because I remember when I made a presentation in 2013 in Delhi with a very august audience, IAS expert, IT experts of the country, they were all analyzing my project of digital literacy. Digital literacy, that is mass literacy, digital mass literacy. Then we made a proposal that this digital literacy program has to be taken to the masses. We told them that we had to use computers and smartphones, and we must go to the rural hamlets. We had to go there, our trainers, they had to go there and teach literacy and illiteracy there itself, there only. They are not supposed to us to come to our classrooms to learn literacy or illiteracy. Then everybody was objecting, no, we cannot support you, because this is a Government of India project, Government of India funds. These PCs, the computers, has to be kept only in the rooms. We cannot take it out to the masses. Then I said, please, I don't want this project. I don't want your money, but we'll go ahead. But one of the IAS officer, he was a secretary, he stood up. He said, no, we have to go to the masses. Only when you go to the masses, they will come to you. Nobody will come to your library. You have to go to them. You have to educate them. You have to give them lessons how the books can transform them, transform you. That you have to go to them. Panicker has achieved literacy, library movement, his strongest library movement, and literacy was, his philosophy is going to the grassroots level, meeting the poorest of the poor, making them aware about the books and the strength of the reading content. That only brought Kerala to this level, because the historians, the British historians say that Kerala labor movement is the cornerstone for Kerala's development that was laid by Mr. P.N. Panicker. Then only we had this, our life expectancy is more, our child mortality is less, we have a very good health system, we have a very good educational system. That is all only because of this literacy and library movement. Now these libraries has to be transformed. These libraries, it is not a mere place for keeping books. Actually, this should be a place for worship. Worship in the sense that we have to empower them. That these libraries has to be a place of place for social development. It's a place for knowledge, what you call it, knowledge dissemination. It's a place for, yes, it has to be developed as a place for, placed as a knowledge hub, a development hub. And now our innovation is, we are making libraries as nodal health centers also, because it's telemedicine. We are practicing telemedicine. The telemedicine has come into existence because of our insight and other things. This, because in the world over, poverty is the main reason for our downward trend. Poverty. The main reason of poverty is ill health. Ill health is due to poverty. So we must have a healthy citizen. So we have to practice telemedicine in all our libraries with cost-effective telemedicine, that you can take the lead. You can take the lead to practice telemedicine in all our village libraries. Once the village libraries are equipped with telemedicine activities, public will come. And that library can be the knowledge hub. Now, you don't have to go to schools, you don't have to go to universities and technical institutions to acquire knowledge. Now, this digital literacy system, digital history and digital library, you can access. Yesterday, my colleague, Dr. Vignesh, was telling me 50 lakhs books can be accessed through a village library. Am I correct, Mr. Dr. Vignesh? 50 lakhs of books can be accessed through village digital library. Our digital technology has developed to that level. So we are getting knowledge, we are getting skill empowerment, we are getting everything. Now the latest concept is your dining table at your home. The dining table, while sitting in your dining table with a PC, you can earn money through e-commerce. You can learn through this, you can empower knowledge through surfacing through different colleges and different libraries. And you can have your health controlled through telemedicine. And you can have what you call entertainment through that PC. You can access social media through PC. You don't have to go out of your home for your livelihood. And so it has come to your home. Now it has come to your home, but we want you to develop libraries in such a way that it will really serve the purpose of a near real knowledge hub in that area for the poorest of the poor. They must come to the library and they must empower themselves. That should be your motive. And you can do some innovation to make it more effective and more functional to the common man. That should be your concept. That should be your because this initiative was started years back. China, Russia, and most of the countries have initiated because during the Russian war, the wife of Lenin, Krupskaya initiated total literacy. UNESCO has constituted an award in the name of Krupskaya. The best practitioner for literacy, and it went up in 1975. That award was backed by Indrasala Sangam, headed by Mr. P.N. Panicker. UNESCO Award 1975. Krupskaya Literacy Award went to PN Panicker and his library, Ganasala Sangham, because for penetrating the grassroots level, she, during the revolution, Russian revolution, most of the population were illiterate. Lenin's wife took it as a program, made Russians literate. This happened in China. Now in India, Mahatmaji conceived literacy. He wanted everybody to take literacy. He wanted to have literacy at the grassroots level. So he wanted to wipe off illiteracy from India. Now Gandhiji, as you know, Gandhiji is considered to be one of the world's hero, and he is considered to be the Ahimsa man of the world. The UN celebrated his birthday as, non-violence day, because Gandhiji is the real inspiration for the entire world. Justice Krishna Iyer, when our foundation's founder chairman, he used to tell us, you will see Gandhiji in China, because Gandhian philosophy and Gandhian ideologies were practiced by Mao Zedong in his own style. In the world, the largest number of biogas plants are in China. The largest number of biogas plants are in China. The biogas plants were conceived by J.C. Kumarappa and Gandhiji to make our environment free, environment more friendly, waste conversion for value addition. Waste conversion to value addition was practiced by Mahatma Gandhi and J.C. Kumarappa in 30s and 40s. That has been adopted by China. The largest number of biogas plants are in China. And Gandhiji conceived that every home should be a production center. Every home should be a production center. You will see the same thing in China. China, every home is a production center. You are enjoying the mobile phone, it is produced at China. You are enjoying the computers, that is produced at China. You are having the fans, your electronic gadgets, produced at China. Because every home a production center. China has become the global leader now, the developed state. China has become the developed state. China has become the developing wonder. Why can't we, India? India can also become the development wonder, provided we do something. That is why that libraries should be skill development center. Libraries should be skill development centers also. You must give them skill development for the poorest of the poor, to enhance our productivity. To enhance our productivity, the library should be the focal point for skill development. So the people will come, they will read, they'll acquire knowledge, they will empower with skills also. They can go for productive employment, because we need resources. We need production. China has become the largest manufacturer, largest producer of the world. The Chinese goods are available in the wayside. It is very cheap, cost effective. We are buying the Chinese goods, but we are not producing. Why can't we produce? We can also produce. We should produce. How it can be produced? Only through knowledge. Only through knowledge it can be produced. And all our products should have excellence. Then only we can market it. We need marketing. Only when you market your product, you will get resources. You have to market it, for which you require knowledge. To acquire knowledge, you have to learn from the libraries. Library should be the place for knowledge empowerment. So we are at this changing scenario, we have to reposition libraries. That's why I'm happy Dr. Shadi he wants to reposition the libraries with technology. In this era of knowledge economy, he is transforming the libraries into a nodal center where the poorest of the poor can also acquire knowledge, and he can be self-sufficient. That should be your motive also. Gandhian principles and inspiration should be taken up in a big way. He has taught us to, Vivekananda's, each one teach one. But Gandhiji was a practitioner of Vivekananda's principles, each one teach one. He made India independent only because of the people's movement. Because we, the librarians, that's why I in the outset, I congratulate you and I saluted you. The you librarian, you have got a higher responsibility. The librarian has to lead the villagers. They have to be led by you. You have to be the model to them because you are giving them knowledge empowerment. That's a great, divine task for you. That's why I salute librarians. It's a profession which is having a divine touch. Because now we are respecting teachers. Why? Teachers have given us lessons of learning. Like that, you are above the teacher. You are giving lessons to the villagers, the poorest of the poor. They don't have any access. You are giving them lessons of knowledge. And these libraries, that we have to transform library from the present library system, library concept, keeping it as a mere storage of books to a real vibrant media for knowledge empowerment. I'm not, because I don't want to trouble you a lot, because you want to learn a lot of lessons from Shadi and Dr. Vijay Kumar, Vignesh and Nancy, etc. And I am sure that your 3 days camp in Kerala will give you much insight. You can go back to your places and you can make that area. Now we are all focusing on panchayat-centric development. We are all because Gandhian concept. The democracy will have vibrancy only with the people's participation. Gandhi taught us panchayat-centric development. We must go for panchayat-centric development. We must organize Gram Sabhas. Only through Gram Sabhas, the poorest of the poor can also express his voice for development, citizen-centric development. We need citizen-centric development to make people more citizen-centric development. I want librarians to take the lead. That's why I am once again saluting you for choosing this profession. Thank you.